Hey everyone, and welcome. Today my job is pulling queens out of mating nucs, caging them for sale. So I'm going to talk you through a little bit about how we do that, and specifically addressing a question that I would get quite a lot is how I mark queens. So I'm going to pull a mating nuc over here in just a minute, but first to explain why we would mark our queens. And the first reason is just to make them more visible in the hive. With just a bright paint mark on them, they're easier to spot, so we can find them faster, know where they are, and make sure they don't get damaged. And the second reason is we mark our queens with a specific color depending on the year. And that allows us to know how old a queen is, or which year she was mated when we see her in our hives. So the color system we use for that, it's a 5-year cycle. And it goes white, yellow, red, green, blue. And this year, 2019, is green. So we can use the phrase, will you raise good bees, to remember that system as the colors go through the year. So green is 2019, and if I'm looking through my hives and spot red queens, I would know that they were mated and raised last year. And if I see yellow queens, I would know that they're just into their third season now. So that can help you with a system of management if you're replacing queens on a schedule, or if you're breeding queens and you want to keep track of them year after year and make sure you know which queen is in that colony, that a queen hasn't been replaced, you'll be able to know by the paint mark that's on her. Okay. So pulling queens out of mating nucs is usually a nice job. These are really small units, not a lot of bees, a lot of young bees, so I usually don't have to wear a veil. I usually have a smoker going, but it's really not something that's crucial for this task, so it's a nice job that we get to do. These mating nucs are styrofoam ones made by Man Lake, and I use some of these and some other ones that I'll show you after too. Okay, so these mating nucs work, they have two different sides to them. This is one unit here with their entrance, and this is a second unit here with their entrance on opposite sides. They hold three of these little frames, and these frames actually look like this. These frames are actually the same depth as Langstroth mediums, but their width, the top bar is chopped in half. So half the width, but the same depth as a medium. And I find these, really easy to work with, also easy to make myself. You can see here is a cell cup from the queen cell that I put in 2 weeks ago. I do all my queen mating on a 2-week schedule. From the day I put in the cell, I return in 2 weeks to look for a mated queen. And I find 2 weeks works really well in our environment in southern Ontario. With average weather, 2 weeks is an adequate amount of time. There are some times where I return to still find virgins. That's likely maybe because of delayed hatching or delayed mating because of an extended period of really bad weather. You know, to make these profitable for all the management that goes into them, I really find if you want to start waiting longer than 2 weeks, it's almost not worth the effort. So if you can manage them on a strict 2-week schedule, then it's more worth your time. Okay, so the first thing I do when I pull out frames of these nucs is just start looking for eggs. Obviously, I try and spot a queen, but I want to make sure that there are eggs in here. That'll let me know that there is a laying queen right away. In this case, there are lots of eggs in the empty spaces here. Okay, so as soon as I know that there's lots of eggs on these frames, then I know I have a queen that has been mated successfully and she's currently laying. So I just need to find this queen, and then I can grab her marker and put her in a cage. So she's not on the second frame, but I just glanced down in the box and I can see her on that third frame. So my queen's right here, and I'll grab her. Okay, so here's my queen. I apologize for how dirty my fingers are. As you can imagine, that's the way things go when you're working with bees. You can see her abdomen. This one is, she's entirely a golden color, but it's her thorax in the middle that we make sure we handle the queen by. So I pick them up off the frames by the thorax like this. I know some people will handle them by the wings, which can be done just fine. As long as you're careful to grab both wings at once. If you happen to pick up a queen by just one wing and she starts, you know, crawling around and trying to walk away from you, it can be not a great situation. And sometimes you'll get other bees coming on your fingers like this. So I'm gonna get my paint marker and I'll show you how I put the dot on our queen. Sorry, I'm trying to do this through the camera viewfinder. Okay. With my paint marker, you can just gently draw on her thorax like this. So that's a quick green dot, and you can tell this paint marker is nice and bright, vibrant green, so it'll be easy to pick out inside the colony. So she's ready to put into a cage now. These are the cages that I'm using, and we call these the California mini cage, but maybe in California they just call them cages or mini cages. And they have just one opening in them, and that's what I'm gonna make sure I run the queen into. So put her head first, and then she should walk in there. And then I just keep my finger over the cage hole end. So now I need to put attendants in this cage because this queen is going to be sold. Or I may just be using this for myself, but she's gonna be in a cage for a little while. So I actually pick up attendant worker bees and put them in with her. And I make sure that they come out of this same nuc that the queen was mated in. Okay, so when I pick up attendant bees, you can take any frame. Here's that first frame with eggs that I pulled out of this out of this small nuc. I'm just gonna set a frame right on top here gently. Careful not to squish any bees. Make sure I'm in focus there. And I typically grab attendant workers by their wings. I know I said I grab the queen by the thorax, but I'll grab workers by their wings just from behind, come up to any bee and try and grab both wings just like this. And then she is ready to go into the cage. Might be easier for you to see off of this frame here. There's more bees. So I make sure I grab, I put at least five attendants into the cage with each queen. It's fairly easy to grab workers that are just walking around on the comb. It's a little harder from behind a camera. But the easiest thing to do, and I should try and show you close up, is to grab a worker whose head is in a cell. For example, here is a bee that's feeding in that cell. Oh, she's just popped her head out. But in that position, they're fairly easy to grab by the wings, just like this. And I'll put her in. Okay. So this cage now has our queen and about six attendants in there. So I need to plug this end. Okay, so these cages come with a tube that's full of the queen candy right here. And since there's only one hole, then I just need to stick that tube into there and she's ready to go. Okay, now that I've marked this queen, caged her with attendants, I just put this back together. But one of the things I just wanted to explain about these tiny, small mating nucs is that they require a lot of management. So I wanted to tell you a little bit about that. I've got this box here, which I'll bring over so you can see it. Okay, This is a box of empty frames. You can see it's actually a standard medium Langstroth box that I've just screwed in an extra, I call it a frame hanger, in the middle. So this will actually fit 20 of my mini frames in it. But as I work my little units on a 2-week schedule, I need to make sure, first of all, that they're well fed. So they clearly are right now. There's actually lots of honey in these frames, and they're building wax a lot right now. But that's what these middle sections are for, actually feeding your bees. So all through May and June and even into July, depending on the nuc, the state of each individual nuc, I'm feeding it sugar syrup. But in the same way that they can require a lot of feeding, they can also become plugged up with too much honey quite quickly too, or brood. As you can see, this colony had this one frame with two sides of capped brood. That would have been from the queen that I pulled out 2 weeks ago. She would have laid those full, and they're capped brood now. This frame at the back, let me pull this out quickly. This has lots of capped brood on this side, lots of honey, and then this sort of empty looking space to you is actually full of eggs and medium aged larvae, honey all around it. And the front frame was full of both honey and eggs from this newest queen. So I don't want these nucs to get too full. As the year goes on and all this brood hatches out, they can become quite full quite quickly. So what I can do as I'm managing them is set aside, maybe I'll leave this one in. It had the larva on one side, capped brood on that side. This one had lots of bees, eggs, and larva. And I can just put in an empty frame, or in this, here's a frame with just foundation. If they're on a really good nectar flow, you'll want to give them foundation so they don't plug these up too much. But in this case, I'm just going to put in an empty frame like this. And this frame with all the older capped brood can just sit here for now. And probably along the line here, I'll find a nuc that may have had a queen that didn't take in it, and it's weaker for whatever reason, and I can boost it up or rebuild it with this good frame. But in the meantime, this one's good to go. I like to keep them, you know, sort of 2 frames out of 3 strong, but make sure they have lots of empty space too, as long as they're on a good nectar flow like they are now. And then I just work the other side. So I just loosen up the frames a little bit and then very gently pull out the first one, because there's not always a lot of space, and start looking for eggs. There's eggs on this first frame, and I actually spot the mated queen right here. Okay, here's my second queen, and can you see she's another mostly light colored but sort of dark at the end of her abdomen. But my queens are in any number of colors. Some of them completely black, some of them completely golden, lots of them in between with different bandings and things like that. So I make no attempts to select for the color. It just happens to be whatever they are. So here's the second one. Make sure I do this well. These are relatively fine tip markers and they do the job. So most people will ask me, what type of markers do you use? And I don't think it really matters. These ones are the brand CraftSmart, which I buy at Michael's here in Canada. But any art supply craft store is going to have paint pens. And these are specifically water-based, these ones. They do make an oil-based one as well, but don't buy that one. The water-based ones, they say non-toxic on the packaging, and those are the ones that I prefer. You'll find variances. I mean, some brands, I mean, I've had experience with Sharpie brand, Elmer's brand, another one that starts with a P, I forget. But they're all a little bit different. And even within one brand, different colors can be quite different in terms of their longevity, their durability, and actually how well they stand out on the bee. So you're gonna have to just figure out what works for you, what you can get, and experiment. Over here on the left is a bee feeding, so I can easily grab her by both wings just like that and put her in the cage. That queen wanted to pop out there and I just stopped her. And here's another one here with her wings up feeding. And I can grab her quite easily and put her in. Okay, this is the type of mating nuc that I probably have more of than the styrofoam style, but I make them myself. So just a simple lid. This is not a great example because it's not painted. And then these little inner covers I just have made out of masonite. They're not ideal either because they don't stand up to moisture very well. But I'll show you. They're nice because I can just open one side at a time. So, well, here's a good example of what can happen. These nucs, I've made them to handle actually four of these exact same frames as the other kind. This one has three and I haven't added the fourth yet. So the bees have actually started to use that space for themselves, and it can get to be a bit of a mess if you're not on top of things. So this is, actually there's my queen right there, but this is honey, and you can see this side capped honey, and they've started to make some comb in between. So I've caught them just in time. I'm gonna grab this queen while I have the opportunity. And this nuc looks this way because I get them established as small units, typically with only two frames, and then I add more frames as they require them. So this one I've caught just in time, and I'll make sure that it should pop off. And so that's a good opportunity to add something like this foundation. Well, it has a bit of comb built on this side, but I'll add this in. Actually, I'll probably put it this way. And that's the four frame unit. That's as big as they can get, and I have to keep managing them from there. This side is done. That's its inner cover back on. This side is also the same three frames, but they haven't started building any new comb yet, which is great. They haven't made a mess yet. And this is good too. I've got a queen on this side. And this nuc looks like it's in pretty good condition, and I'll add a fourth frame here too. This style of nuc, it's obviously relatively simple to make. There's a divider just in the middle here. Entrances on both sides. They have their main entrance at the bottom, the only entrance actually at the bottom. This upper hole actually has screen, it's just for ventilation. And that's one thing that these little units you have to be very careful with. Depending on your specific climate, these might not work well for you. If it gets too hot or too cold, they're not ideal. That's why the styrofoam ones are made of the material that they are, to insulate the bees from the heat, but also if it gets too cold, they're relatively well protected that way too. My wooden ones are not the same. I could actually have some insulation maybe built onto the lid just on top. And if I was to build more of these or improve the ones that I have built, I would add more ventilation. Because I do find on really hot days, the bees like to be out on the front of the box more so than actually inside of it. So I think they could do with more ventilation. Okay, two queens from there. So that's my sort of long-winded explanation of my mating nuc system and marking queens. I hope you were able to get some value out of that. Picked up some tidbits here and there. I will say though, like I think I said earlier, if you're not very experienced with bees in terms of fairly intensive management, I would avoid these small mating units, but I would encourage every beekeeper to try to be self-sustaining, self-sufficient. And so what I'd recommend more for beginners is just to make, you know, four-frame nucs or something like that out of standard size Langstroth equipment that you can pull frames, and they're easier to maintain. They have more of a buffer from becoming too full or declining too quickly. So that would be my advice to beginners. Start with standard size equipment in like a four-frame nuc before you move on to something as small as these. I also need to say, I'm sure it's going to be asked, that I make no efforts to overwinter these little units. These are purely made up from scratch in the spring, late spring, early summer. They go through the summer, multiple rounds of queen mating, and then I tear them apart again before winter starts. And my last piece of advice when it comes to marking queens is, if you're not comfortable handling queens and actually putting a paint mark on them, is to practice on drones. So we all know that drones don't sting, they're easy to handle, you'll be more confident, and you won't have to worry about something going wrong, and you can try out your different paint markers and hope that works. So yeah, I just wanted to say thanks for watching my video, and check out some more on my channel, and hopefully I'm making a few more soon.